tourists killed in Kampala during a mosque raid. Old girl drowns in Kasese following heavy rain. And the tale of losing a child due to costly oxygen in government health facilities.
Your mama teach your manners. The lecture never taught you manners or teach you manners. The business manners, the rap manners. You know how we do it with the animals.
Nachali wange mwagala nnyo nze naye tuvudde wala nnyo bwali mwana nga kinuma nnyo naye ate amawulire agasoma nnyo
bwasoma nnyo amawulire mukwano choyo
mukwano bamuyita fefebusi
but your fefebusi. Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to PM Live Celebrity Edition. My name is Victoria Namtabiliwaga and our guest anchor tonight is none other than the man for the battle, who is who? Fefe Busi, welcome to
Yo,
the show.
It's a pleasure being here.
How are you feeling?
I'm good.
Are you ready for the challenge?
I'm more than ready.
What is Fefe Busi, by the way? Like, what, how did you come up with this name? What language is it, and why?
Fefe, I looked out for something so unique.
Okay.
Yeah, the people that would make that something that would make Victoria ask me, where did you get that? You
okay.
Know? Yeah, but Fefe is the nickname that I got when I was still young. You know, those nicknames you get when you're still young. Then Busi comes from the word business.
Hey, yeah, so you're all about business?
You know?
Fefe Busi.
Yeah.
Go to our social media pages at Urban TV Ghana on Twitter, Urban Television on Facebook, and rate his anchoring skills from a scale of 1 to 10. Also, ask those questions that you want him to answer tonight, whether you want him to tell us what's going on between him and Gravity, or him and Fik Fameka, or whether he's seeing someone, just ask your questions on social media at Urban TV Ghana, Twitter, Urban TV Ghana, Facebook. But for now, time to get into the news. You ready?
Yo, I'm ready.
Let's go.
Okay. Yo. Two suspected terrorists have been shot dead in Kampala as security agents carried out the arrest of the Magara suspected killer, who was hiding in Musafi Mosque in Chisenyi, a Kampala suburb. This operation was carried out last night at about 10 p.m. following credible intelligence that one of the key suspects in the murder of Susan Magara had run to the mosque, having known that he was being tracked by security agencies. Here are the details.
According to eyewitnesses, Musafi Mosque at Kisenyi, a Kampala suburb, almost turned into a war zone for close to 7 hours last night as security agencies carried out the raid, with bullets flying all over. Upon a visit to the scene of crime this morning, bloodstains and spent cartridges were evident.
Tiagas yakomisa nga munana. Bakubye bakuba mu bitundu byeri waggulu nnyo nga bakuba amasasi amangi kati ffe twagenze okuba nga abafuluma nga baseeka abantu abo abantu basatu
saawa bbiri ez'ekiro naye amasasi okutabuka ennyo ennyo byatandise saawa ttaano byawedde saawa mwenda amasasi ne bakuba abaana baffe bonna abato mu buliri tiyagasa ababadde beebase.
The whole place remained heavily guarded and sealed off by the security agencies for further investigations. In a joint news conference at Media Center, security agencies said the raid at the mosque followed the credible evidence that one of the key suspects in the murder of Susan Magara was hiding there, having known that he was being tracked by the agencies. In the ensuing scuffle, two people armed with pangas attacked security forces but were shot dead.
Those in the mosque attacked the security forces and in fact fatally injured one of the security operatives. So the death of these two was in self-defense so that they would not continue to hurt other security operatives in this operation.
A sizable number of suspects were arrested and a number of weapons used in committing these heinous crimes have been seized.
In the mosque, the security forces report they found 18 women and 94 children of different nationalities who had been kept there for an unspecified period of time. The police are making arrangements to identify and hand over the rescued children and women to their relatives.
There was a key suspect being followed up, and in the process of following up, this suspect went to Usafi Mosque. We found that there were children whom we are still investigating, but we believe they were kidnapped. They were under the hands of these people.
It is important for you to know that we will continue with this investigation. This is only part of that investigation.
36 suspects were arrested and a number of weapons used in committing crimes were seized. These included 60 rounds of ammunition, one bow and arrow, 23 double-edged pangas, and one laptop. The hunt down for the suspects behind the recent kidnaps for ransom is still going on. Security agencies have issued phone contacts, which the public can call on to provide information regarding any whereabouts of the other suspects still on the run.
You can use the following numbers provided here. 0712-66705 or 0714-66743, or provide this information to the nearest police station in your locality.
The mosque will continue to be secured and restricted as investigations continue. The general public has been called upon to keep calm as security agencies continue to secure the country in the fight against crime. Report by Jaliat Namwaya for Urban TV.
You're watching PM Live. Now, local authorities and residents in Maliba sub-county, Kasese district, are still searching for the body of a 16-year-old girl who is said to have drowned in a river. Locals say although they haven't yet found the body, they are pessimistic that the girl could have fallen into River Kataranda after heavy rains. Now, these, however, accuse the government for not revamping the bridge that has been broken for a while now.
Relatives, local authorities and sorrowful parents of a 16-year-aged girl identified as Yerisa Muhindu are yet to find her body, assumed to be in River Kataranda, which is found in Maliba sub-county, Kasese district. According to the relatives, today marks the third day ever since their daughter was swept away by this river. Residents of this place noted that they had spent years pestering local government leaders to fix the bridge, but in vain. By press time, patient searchers were still looking for the body, and according to relatives, burial arrangements will be announced after finding it. For a couple of weeks, strong downpours have been hitting the western region, causing the destruction of gardens, homesteads, birds, and animals. Report filed by Hudson Kagure.
For that report, you're watching PM Live Celebrity Edition, and Fefe Busi is our guest anchor tonight.
Yeah.
Fefe, what's your take on Uganda's music industry?
On Uganda's music industry, I think it's growing.
Okay.
Yeah, I think it's more fun, and I think it's paying.
And you think it's paying? Yeah. So you've made some money.
Yeah.
Are we going to share money?
No.
Fefe has made money, but we are not sharing his money.
No, it's sharing.
Okay. So why the who is who challenge?
Why the who is who challenge?
Oh, battle.
I don't call it a battle. I would prefer to call it a challenge.
Okay.
Because it has become more of a challenge.
Okay.
But the chemistry behind the who is who thing, it's hip hop. Like raising the hip hop back in Uganda. I would say the last time I had hip hop booming in Uganda, it was those times of GNLs, you know, when they were topping the charts. Now we were missing this conk hip hop, the original hip hop. So that's the magic behind.
So you decided to come with a challenge,
you know,
so that you can bring back more hip hop guys on board, or to raise the upcoming one,
to raise the hip hop voices. Yeah, and thank God, hip hop is taking over now. Hip hop is back.
Okay, so in one of your songs, we hear you talk about bubblegum music.
Yeah.
What's bubblegum music?
Bubblegum music is music that doesn't last so long, is music that doesn't influence anyone, that doesn't inspire. Music that just come and goes.
Like which one?
You want to kill me?
No, I didn't kill you. I just asked a question.
Which one? You know.
No, I don't know. Tell
don't
me.
Kill me, please.
Okay.
I will not specialize in one kind of artist who is doing that kind of music, the bubblegum music. But you know that kind of music that just comes and fades away in 1 week.
Okay.
And you don't want to remember it. Like you can't even play it after some time.
Okay.
Yeah, that's so bubblegum music.
And your kind of music?
Oh, it's not the usual music. Yeah.
<That's Some
laughs> Take over, break is over, nigga. Best MC and they all over. And oh, just beginning, Muganda beginning. Can I see Kakunon attention, publication, nomination, canocalation, generation, sicker beef session, the vegetarian, sensitization, in Zuxa Nation. You know,
I like beginning.
You like the beginning? You know,
well,
it's just the beginning.
Okay, it's just the beginning. Of PM Live Celebrity Edition. We're going to take a short break, return with a lot more stories, and Fefe Busi is going to be opening up more about very many things that he's doing in the music industry. So stay tuned to Urban TV.